إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance we have is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. Everything we newly invent into this deen of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. Every innovation is misguidance and leads astray. وكل ضلالة في النار. Every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters, in Islam, year after year, we're faced with hearing about those amongst the Ummah who are celebrating the birth of the Prophet ﷺ. So it is upon us to remind ourselves what has come down in the Quran and the Sunnah regarding these innovative matters, because that's what it is. And what should our position be? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبْيَانًا بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ. We have revealed or sent down the book to you, O Muhammad ﷺ, the Quran, as an explanation for everything. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ مَا فَرَّطْنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. And we have not neglected one thing from this book. Nothing has been neglected from the book of Allah. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمْ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. Allah says, what means that this day I have perfected for you your religion and completed my favor upon you and chosen for you al-Islam as your deen. ثم قال الله قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. Allah says, what means say, O Muhammad ﷺ, that indeed if you love Allah, then follow me. This following of me means following His Sunnah. Then Allah will love you and forgive you your sins. ثم قال الله ومن يطع الرسول فقد أطاع الله. And Allah said, what means, and whoever obeys the Messenger ﷺ, this is the person who has obeyed Allah. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. And Allah said, what means, whatever the Messenger of Allah ﷺ gives you, take it, follow it, implement it. Whatever he prohibits you from, then you stay away from it. وَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ لَا يُؤْمِنُ عَبْدٌ حَتَّى أَكُونَ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ أَهْلِهِ وَمَالِهِ وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ. رواه مسلم. And Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said that none of you, that a servant does not completely have faith until I am more beloved to him than his family, than his wealth, than all of mankind. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ قُلْ أَطِيعُ اللَّهُ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولُ فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّمَا عَلَيْهِ مَا حُمِّلَ وَعَلَيْكُمْ مَا حُمِّلْتُمْ وَإِنْ تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدَوْا وَمَا عَلَى الرَّسُولِ إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينُ. Allah says, what means, say, obey Allah and obey His Messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. But if you turn away from this, if you turn away from this, then he, the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, is only responsible for the duty he placed, that is placed on him, to convey the message of Allah, and you for that which is placed on you. If you obey him, you shall be on the right guidance. Following the Prophet ﷺ is part of being on that right guidance. And Allah's words is proof enough. And the Messenger ﷺ's duty is only to convey the message in a clear way. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, besides all of this, we hear more and more ayat and hadith, as we're going to see. So how do we celebrate the birth of the Prophet ﷺ when we don't value and cherish and live the message that he came and delivered to all of mankind? We claim we love him, but who really does love him? And is that love true if we're not implementing his sunnah and we're giving it up just to stay upon the culture that we've been taught? There's no true celebration of the life of the Prophet ﷺ, nor his birth, nor his message that he came with, except when you implement the Quran and the sunnah. You follow what he gave us in the sunnah. You stay away from what he forbade. Doing what he said, staying away from what he prohibited. كَانَ خُلْقُهُ الْقُرْآنَ as Aisha radiallahu anha said, his character was the Qur'an. He was living every bit, every harf, every letter of that book. The Prophet ﷺ lived it out and implemented it. So enact the sunnah that he taught us. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, الْقَصْدُ فِي السُنَّةِ خَيْرٌ مِنْ اجْتِهَادٍ فِي بِدْعَةٍ. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, moderation with the sunnah is better than putting all this effort and time and energy into doing a bid'ah. And you see this the most concerning the mawlid, concerning the birth of the Prophet ﷺ. So much energy, so many lengths taken, so much money spent. Yet if you did something much less from the sunnah, it would be much more beloved to Allah, because that innovation will be rejected. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this is a deen where we have specified how to purify ourselves in the restroom, how to take a bath, how to put on our clothing, how to eat, how to leave and enter our homes and our masajid, what to say on every occasion, whether it's the time for, there's thunder, there's heavy winds, or whatever it may be. This is how complete our deen is. So we're that detailed to even how to use the restroom. But somewhere in the mix of all that, we lost, or it was missed, that we had to celebrate the birth of the Prophet ﷺ, when the Prophet ﷺ himself said, you only have 2 days of Eid, 2 days of celebration. Shaykh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah, in Al-Asul al-Thalatha, the three fundamental principles, he said, مَعْنَ شَهَادَةِ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ طَاعَتَهُ فِيمَا أَمَرْ وَتَصْدِيقُهُ فِيمَا أَخْبَرْ واجتناب ما عنه نهى وزجر وألا يعبد الله إلا بما شرع. The meaning of when you say أشهد أن محمد رسول الله or عبده رسوله. What does this mean? Because it just means, oh, Muhammad is my messenger. No, it has meanings and it has conditions. From its meanings of this testimony that Muhammad is your messenger, is your prophet that you follow, the messenger of Allah, it is that you obey him in what he commanded. You believe in everything he informed us of, even if science were to say something different. You avoid what he's prohibited and disavowed. You take it as haram, even if science tells you that there's halal or good in it. And only worshipping Allah with what he legislated. These four must be present if you say the shahada, for your shahada that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, for it to be accepted. One day the Prophet ﷺ, he led the companions in prayer and he faced them and gave them a legendary exhortation. They began to cry and to weep, saying, is this your final time? You're going to give us a khutbah. If it is, tell us something that would be an injunction we could live by. فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أُوصِيكُمْ بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ وَالسَّمْعِ وَالطَّاعَةِ وَإِنْ كَانَ عَبْدًا حَبَشِيًّا فَإِنَّهُ مَنْ يَعِشْ مِنْكُمْ يرى اختلافا كثيرا فعليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين تمسكوا بها وعدوا عليها بالنواجذ وإياكم محدثات الأمور فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة. This mentioning of كل بدعة is not a word that we made up or came up with. It was from the lips of our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He told them at this time, he said, I enjoin upon you to fear Allah, to fear your Lord and keep your duty to him, and to listen and to obey to you, the ruler. Even if it's an Abyssinian slave who rules over you. For those of you who live after me, you will see a lot of disagreement. Like we see in our time, a lot of disagreement. So what is upon you? فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّتِي. Then upon you is to follow my sunnah. وَسُنَّةُ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَهْدِينَ. And to follow the sunnah of the rightly guided khulafa. Abu Bakr, Umar, Ali, Uthman, رضي الله عنهم وارضاهم, in the order of how they are the best in this ummah after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Upon you is to follow me and the sunnah, my sunnah, and to follow the khulafa al-rashidin al-mahdiyin min ba'di. Hold on to it. Stick fast to it. Bite on to it with your molar teeth. Do not let go of it. Avoid every invented matter. For every invented matter is an innovation, and every innovation is misguidance and leads astray. عن عائشة رضي الله عنها أم المؤمنين, the mother of the believers. She said that Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. Whoever says something that is not legislated in Islam, it's not from what Islam gave us, Allah and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, it's going to be rejected. وقالت إن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من عمل عملا ليس عليه أمرنا فهو رد. Whoever does an action that is not prescribed in the Quran and the Sunnah, then it's going to be rejected as well. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we look at the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, لَا تَطْرُونِ كَمَا أَطْرَةِ النَّصَارِ ابْنَ مَرْيَمْ فَإِنَّمَا أَنَا عَبْدُهُ فَقُلُ عَبْدَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولَهُ. The Messenger of Allah ﷺ, he said in an authentic hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, do not exaggerate in praising me like the Christians have the son of Mary, Jesus alayhi salam. For indeed I am the slave of Allah, so call me Allah's servant and Allah's messenger. This is what is upon us. So the Prophet ﷺ did not order or command the celebrating of his birth. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum, who loved him, who cried for him, who sacrificed their life to defend him, took spears to protect him. None of them ever celebrated the birth of the Prophet ﷺ. The four Imams, Abu Hanifa, Malik, Shafi'i, Imam Ahmed, rahimahullah, may Allah have mercy on them. None of them ever are recorded to have said or to celebrate the Prophet's birthday, nor to command it amongst their students. You have 400 years after Islam, after the Prophet died, where there's no mention of the celebration of the birth of the Prophet. And yet, now we have made it such a big festival. It's crept into many communities. And this is a bid'ah, an innovation that will be rejected. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, look closely. وَمَنْ يَشَاقِقْ الرَّسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّيهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُسْلِيهِ جَهَنَّمْ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Allah says what means that whoever contradicts and opposes the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after the right path has been shown clearly to him and follows other than the believer's way, we will keep them on the path that they have chosen, and they will burn in the hellfire. What an evil destination that would be. An evil destination. If you oppose Allah and you oppose His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it is clearly an innovation. An innovation that will be rejected. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من تشبه بقوم فهو منهم. Abu Huraira, he narrates that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, whoever imitates a people, then he is from them. And this is in the Sunan of Abu Dawud, and Ibn Hibban, he graded it as sahih. We take the Prophet ﷺ as our role model, and the one we want to follow his example. And this is what he is, because Allah said, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوا اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. Allah says what means indeed in the Messenger of Allah ﷺ, you have the best example. For him who hopes in the meeting with Allah and the last day and remembers Allah much. So all of these things people do, let's be real. All of the innovations, they seem small to the masses. They seem innocent. But in reality, it is all misguidance and it will be rejected. And what has been done has led many people to shirk and to kufr. Because of these small bid'ahs in the eyes of the people, it's led people to make dua to the Prophet ﷺ, or to call on the Prophet ﷺ, or to pray to the Prophet ﷺ. And this is an innovation. This is shirk, this is kufr. Because of something small, so never belittle an innovation. كل بدعة ضلالة. Every innovation is misguidance. وكل ضلالة في النار. Every misguidance and going astray is in the hellfire. In the Muwatta of Imam Malik, rahimahullah, he records that the Prophet ﷺ, he said, تركت فيكم أمرين لن تضلوا ما تمسكتم بهما كتاب الله وسنة نبيه. Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, he said, I've left you with two things. If you hold on firmly to them, you'll never go astray. The Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah says, فَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِهِ وَعَزَّرُوهُ وَنَصَرُوهُ وَاتَّبَعَ النُّورَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ مَعَهُ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمَ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Allah says, what means, so those who believe in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they honor him and they support him and they follow the light which with he was sent, it is them who will be successful. They are the ones who will have success and take success in this life and in the next. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, be aware of these innovations. They may make it look good. It may sound good. What they're calling you to come and do in their presence may look like it's a good thing, but it will be rejected 100 times over. Because every innovation is misguidance. All you have to do is follow what the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came with. Enough of this, my madhab, if you know nothing else but your madhab till now, okay, but when someone comes to you with qala Allah wa qala Rasulullah, if that ain't your madhab, you're in deep trouble. What you have to follow is the Quran and the Sunnah. May Allah make us of those who are firm upon it. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Imam al-Baghdadi in Sharh al-Sunnah, he said, اعلم, know, اعلم, know, know, be ready to listen and hear this. He said, أن الإسلام هو السنة والسنة هي الإسلام. He said, know that Islam is the Sunnah, and the Sunnah is Islam. وَلَا يَقُومُ أَحَدُهُمَا إِلَّا بِالْآخِرِ. You cannot have one without the other. The two go hand in hand, and they cannot be separated. The Quran and the Sunnah, according to how the Sahaba lived it, how they practiced it and implemented it, is what we should be going back to. And we go back to the scholars who refer back to those times. Back to what the Quran said, what to the Prophet ﷺ said, what to the Sahaba said and did, to learn our deen. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بدأ الإسلام غريب غريبة وسيعود غريبة فقوبة للغرباء. رواه ابن ماجة وهذا حديث صحيح. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said Islam began as something strange. This concept of Tawheed, worshipping only one Lord, only calling upon Him, only praying to Him, sacrificing for Him. And guess what? It will return to something strange. Not that worshipping one is strange, but holding on to the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. Why? Because of how much the bid'ah and the innovation has spread. It's like a worm to an apple. Innovations to the sunnah. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ثلاث من كن فيه وجد حلاوة الإيمان وجد من حلاوة الإيمان من كان الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما ومن أحب عبدا لا يحبه إلا لله ومن يكره أن يعود في الكفر بعد إذ أنقذه الله كما يكره أن يلقى في النار. رواه البخاري. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever possesses these three qualities will taste the sweetness of faith. Number one, the one to whom Allah and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم are more beloved and dearer than anyone and anything else. You cannot taste how sweet Iman is until that is true. So if you love even your parents or your children or whoever more than you love Allah and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, you will never taste how sweet faith tastes. Number two is that when you love a person, you love them only for the sake of Allah. Not because they're going to benefit you, not because they're going to bring you some dunya benefit, but you love them just because Allah would love them, or would love their actions. They do the actions of the righteous. And thirdly, that you hate to revert to kufr, to disbelief, to be an atheist, to be a mushrik, to be a disbeliever, just like you would hate to be thrown in the fire. When these three qualities are there, you can taste how sweet faith is. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, let me go through some things because of how important this message is at this time especially. 2023, 1445 after the Hijrah, and we're seeing the Sunnah getting diluted with innovation upon innovation. If you love Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you want Allah to love you and forgive you, then pay attention. If you love Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you stand up for Tawheed and you get rid of any shirk, even if it's part of your culture. Because our cultures are riddled with shirk, we just don't want to admit it and we don't want to leave it. And it could be what drowns you on the day of resurrection in your sweat. So love the sharia that Allah sent through Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Urwa ibn Zubayr, he mentioned, he said that Abdullah ibn Amr, he asked Abdullah ibn Amr, what was the worst thing that the pagans, the mushrikeen, did to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He said, Uqba ibn Mu'ayth, he came to the Prophet while he was praying and took a sheet and put it around his neck and tightened it to choke him. He saw this suffering. Abu Bakr, he came and he fought him, knowing that this man may then kill him. And what did he say for Tawheed? He said, أَتَخْتَرُونَ رَجْلًا أَن يَقُولَ رَبِّي اللَّهُ وَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. Are you going to kill a man just because he says, my Lord is Allah, and he's coming to you with proof, مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ, from your Lord? So stand up for your Tawheed. That's what this deen is, that's what differentiates it from everything else. It's this Tawheed, this oneness of Allah with respect to worshipping Him. And His Lordship and His names and His attributes. If you love Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, learn the adhkar of the morning and the evening. They will help protect you from what you seek protection from. Learn what you should say when you leave your home and enter your home. When you enter the masjid and leave the masjid. When you enter the restroom, leave the restroom. We belittle these things. These are recorded things that our Prophet ﷺ said and did. They will benefit you. If you love Allah and His Messenger ﷺ, pray as He prayed. كَمَا قَالَ صَلُّوا كَمَا رَأَيْتُمُ يُصَلِّي. The command came from Him Himself. When He said, pray as you have seen me praying. Who cares how you prayed before? How your mom and dad taught you? If someone comes to you with a proof on how to pray, follow that. As long as they've given you the proof and it's authenticated. Don't be so rigid to what you've been upon, because the madhab we should follow is that of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you love Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, my brothers, then you come to the masajid for the five daily prayers. Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, he said, وَإِصَلَّيْتُمْ فِي بَيُوتِكُمْ كَمَا يُصَلَّ الْمُتَخَلَّفْ فِي بَيْتِهِ لَتَرَبْتُمْ سُنَّ نَبِيِّكُمْ لَتَرَبْتُمْ سُنَّ نَبِيِّكُمْ وَإِنْ تَرَبْتُمْ سُنَّ نَبِيِّكُمْ لَضَلَّلْتُمْ. Ibn Mas'ud, he said, if you abandon, if you stay and you pray in your homes like the lazy people do, like those lagging behind, you would have left the sunnah of your Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nothing should stop you from coming and worshipping Allah in this home. So come and pray in the masajid. The brothers, the children. Then he said, and if you abandon the sunnah of your Prophet ﷺ, so if you pray in your homes, you're abandoning the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. And if you abandon the sunnah of your Prophet ﷺ, then you have been misguided and disobeyed and been disobedient. If you love Allah and His Messenger ﷺ, straighten your rows, close the gaps, stand shoulder to shoulder, ankle to ankle. Why? Because He commanded it. أُقِيمُوا صُفُوفُكُمْ أُقِيمُوا صُفُوفُكُمْ أُقِيمُوا صُفُوفُكُمْ. Three times he said in an authentic hadith in Bukhari. He said it three times. وَاللَّهِ وَاللَّهِ لَتُقِيمَنَّ صُفُوفَكُمْ أَوْ يُخَالِفَنَّ اللَّهَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ. He said, straighten your lines, because if you don't, Allah is going to put division between your hearts. So why doesn't that translate in our minds if we're seeing the ummah divided? It's because we have gaps in the prayer. If you deny that, you're denying a hadith. Then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قَالَ فَرَأَيْتَ الرَّجُلْ يُلْزِقُ منكبه بمنكب صاحبه وركبته بركبة صاحبه وكعبه بكعبه. Then the narrator of this hadith, النعمان بن بشير, he then says, I said, and Al-Bukhari, he authenticated it, I saw the companions then putting their shoulder against the shoulder of their brother, their knee against the knee of their brother, their ankle against the ankle of their brother. And this is from the highest levels of authenticity. Who's going to deny to stand like that in prayer besides their brothers or for the sisters amongst their sisters? If you love Allah and His Messenger, say the Ameen out loud when the Imam says it. Again, why? Because that's what you were commanded to do. That's what the Prophet did. That's what the Sahaba said. Don't belittle any sunnah. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا أمن القارئ فأمنوا فإن الملائكة تؤمنوا فمن وافق تأمينه بتأمين الملائكة غفر الله ما تقدم من ذنبه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, when the Imam says Ameen, a direction that the Imam should say Ameen, then say Ameen behind him because the angels say Ameen, not before him. And this is a common error too. Some say the Ameen before the Imam starts it. He said, why? Because if your Ameen coincides with the angel's Ameen, Allah will forgive you your minor sins that you've done before. مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. If you love Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then increase in your sunnah prayers, pray your wizard, do your adhkar after each prayer. The angels will be making dua that Allah forgives you, Allah maghfir lahu, Allah marhamhu, Allah forgive him, Allah have mercy upon him. Rabi' al-Makab, he said, I was with the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and I brought him water to do what he wanted to do with it. Then he told me, sell. He said, ask of me. He said, أسألكم رافقتك في الجنة. He said, I ask to be your companion in Jannah. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, أو غير ذلك, you want anything other than this. So Rabi' he said, هو ذاك, that's all I want. All I want is to be with you in Jannah. He said, فأعني على نفسك بكثرة السجود. Then help me to help you by increasing your sujood, meaning the nawafil, the extra prayers, other than the fara'id, other than the five daily ones. You love the Prophet ﷺ? Increase in doing your extra prayers. This is how you show your love. If you love the Prophet ﷺ, take from him your hajj and your umrah rights. خُذُوا عَنِّي مَنَاسِكُكُمْ. If you love the Prophet ﷺ, pray two rak'ahs when you come in the masjid before sitting down. Even if it's during Jum'ah. And if you forget when you remember, stand up and pray them. Sulayk, one of the companions, he entered the masjid and sat down during the Jum'ah khutbah. And the Prophet told him to stand up and pray two rak'ahs. And he said, إِذَا جَاءَ أَحَدَكُمْ يَوْمِ الْجُمْعَةِ وَالْإِمَامِ يَخْطُبْ فَلْيَرْكَ رَكْعَتَيْنِ وَلْيَتَجَوَّزْ فِيهِمَا. He said, pray to get up, pray to rak'ahs. If any of you enters the masjid on the day of Jum'ah and the Imam is giving the khutbah, pray to rak'ahs and make them brief. And we've said this how many times over the years, yet some still come in. They have a stubbornness and an arrogance to just follow what they learned and not wanting to learn it, even though the hadith comes to you straight from Sahih Muslim. If you love Allah and His Messenger, send prayers upon Him. The night of Jum'ah, the day of Jum'ah, 10 times in the morning, 10 times in the evening, Allahumma salli wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. If you love the Prophet, put on your right sock, your right shoe, your right slipper before your left one, and when you take them off, take it off with your left first. If you love the Prophet, say Bismillah before you eat, and Alhamdulillah when you're done eating. Because this was his sunnah. If you love the Prophet, eat and drink with your right hand, and sit when you're drinking. This was the sunnah of your Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you love the Prophet, use the bathroom while sitting down. Use the bathroom while sitting down for the brothers, because still you have those who are opposing that, even when it's clean. If you love the Prophet, follow the acts of the fitrah that he delivered to us, for us to be upon what is pure and clean. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خمس من الفطرة. Five are from the fitrah, al-khitan, wal-istihdad, wa-taqlim al-awafil, wa-nadf al-ibd, wa-qasr al-shawarib, al-sharib, rawahu muslim. There's five acts from the acts of purity and cleanliness, and being born upon the natural disposition. Circumcision,
The clicking of the nails of the fingers and the toes for the men and the women, no longer than 40 days. The shaving of the pubic hair in the private region, no longer than 40 days, male and female. Shaving under the arms, men and women, no longer than 40 days. And the last thing was to shorten the mustache so it is above the lip. It's not hanging over the lip. These are from the acts of fitra, natural disposition. If you love the Prophet, implement them, regardless of what the people think. If you love the Prophet, I'm going to take a little longer today. If you love the Prophet, grow your lihya, grow your beard. It is not a small thing. Don't tell me what other groups are growing it nowadays. So what? You were the ummah that was commanded to grow it. قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ خَالَفُ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. He said, be different than the mushrikeen, than the polytheists. أَوْثِرُ اللِّحَى وَحْفُ الشَّوَارِبِ. He said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, do the opposite of the mushrikeen. Grow your beards, let them get full. And trim the mustache above the lip. The lip. This is the sunnah of our Prophet. This was a command, it was not an option. When we say sunnah, it does not always mean if you want to. If your wife wants to leave you for it, let her leave you. If your mom will get upset with you over it, let her get upset. Because part of that sweetness of faith is what? Is that Allah and His Messenger are more beloved to you than anyone and anything else. If you love the Prophet, oh sisters, be modest. Be shy, wear your hijabs properly. Do not be embarrassed to show your deen. قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ الْإِيمَانِ بِدْعٌ وَسَبْعُونَ شُعْبَةٌ وَالْحَيَاءُ شُعْبَةٌ مِّنَ الْإِيمَانِ. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, faith is of 70 odd branches, modesty and haya is a branch of faith. Wear your hijabs, show your modesty. It will make the people turn maybe and question what is this in a society that's running rampant with nudity and immorality. If you love Allah and His Messenger, stand with what is just and correct, oppose what that which Islam forbade, even if the people will judge you and oppose you. Even if people will dislike us for saying this LGBTQ thing is wrong, that being transgender is wrong, that being homosexual, who cares if they oppose us? We need Allah's approval to get to Jannah, not nobody else's. Stand for what is just and what is right. So much peer pressure to accept everyone and everything. You don't need to. If you love Allah and His Messenger, say Alhamdulillah when you sneeze. Cover your mouth when you yawn. Honor your neighbor and your guest. If you love Allah and His Messenger, have good character and manners. Watch yourself. Be good to the people. Be kind. مَا كَانَ الرِّفْقِ فِي شَيْءٍ لَزَانُهُ. Kindness is not a part of something the Prophet ﷺ said, except that it beautifies it and makes it look good. Be trustworthy, fulfill your oaths and your promises with your family members, with your brothers and sisters, with the disbelievers. If you give an oath, if you give a promise, fulfill it and do not be treacherous to it. If you love Allah and His Messenger ﷺ, smile at somebody. It's a sadaqah for you to just smile at them. And let them see the simplicity of Islam, to let them see the beauty of brotherhood, if it's your brother or sister in Islam. If you love Allah and His Messenger, help those in need. Say what is good or be silent. مَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا أَوْ لِيَصْمُتْ. If you love Allah and His Messenger, love for your brother, your neighbor, the people. What's your love for yourself? لَا يُؤْمِنْ أَحَدَكُمْ حَتَّى يُحِبُّ الْأَخِيهِ. وفي رواية لجاري وفي رواية لنفسه ما للناس ما يحب لنفسه. None of you truly completely believes what you love for your brother in a narration, your neighbor in another narration, the people what you love for yourself. If you love Allah and His Messenger, realize and actualize that there ain't no racism or nationalism in this deen of ours. I don't care what country from you're from, what skin color you have, what language you speak, what degrees you have, how much money you got to your name. You are not better than anybody else in this deen to Allah unless you have more taqwa. كَمَا قَالْ إِنْ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. The best of you in the sight of Allah is the one who has taqwa, who keeps his duty to Allah and fears Allah. Abu Nadra, he said that the Messenger of Allah, he said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ أَلَا إِنَّ رَبَّكُمْ وَاحِدٌ وَإِنَّ آبَاكُمْ وَاحِدٌ أَلَا لا فضل لعربي على عجمي ولا لعجمي على عربي ولا لأحمر على أسود ولا لأسود على أحمر إلا بالتقوى أبلغت. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his farewell khutbah, knowing that it would be preserved for all time, he said, your Lord is one, your father Adam alayhi salam is one. There is no virtue, no betterness to an Arab over a non-Arab, nor a non-Arab over an Arab, nor a black person over a white or red person, nor a white or red person over a black person, except by taqwa. And then he said, أَبَلَّغْتُ, have I not conveyed my message? Do not look down on the people because of the color of their skin or what country they're from or what poverty or richness level they may have or whatever it may be. If you love Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you love them, bury your arguments and your quarrels, make up with your brother. كُونُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِخْوَانَا, be brothers and sisters in faith and deen. المؤمن كالبنيان يشد بعضه بعضا. The believer to the believer is like a building of bricks. One part strengthens the other. Stop tearing each other down. Stop it. We're supposed to help one another. Bring one another up. Help one another in tough times. Instead of all the competition and the backbiting and the slandering and the likes of these matters. Bury your hatchets. If you love Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, do not abandon the sunnah, do not belittle any sunnah, but act upon it. I'm going to leave you with two hadith. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تزال طائفة من أمتي ظاهرين على الحق لا يضرهم من خالفهم ولا من خذلهم حتى تقوم الساعة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in Sahih Muslim, it is reported, there will not cease to be a group from my ummah manifest upon the truth at all times. They are not harmed by those who oppose them nor by those who forsake them until the establishment of the hour. Be from this group. Be from this group. And Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, he narrated that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, يأتي على الناس زمان الصابر فيهم على دينه كالقابض على الجمر. رواه الترمذي وهذا حديث حسن. The Prophet said, there shall come a time when the people have to be patient upon their deen, and it will be like them holding on to a hot burning coal. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, if you love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you love Allah and you love His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, do not celebrate His Mawlid. If someone even brings you a sweet because of its occasion, dump it in the garbage or give it to some poor people. If you love them, then you stick to this deen. This is our Prophet. He cried, Becca, Allahumma ummati, Allahumma ummati. He cried, oh Allah, my ummah, why? He knew we would be tested with the fitna of wealth, with the fitna of women, with the fitna of materialism, with the fitna of arguing and quarreling with one another. He cried, fearing what we would fall into. So if you love him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then follow his sunnah. Avoid the innovations from them, from the biggest of them, this mawlid or celebration of his birthday. You're better off memorizing one ayah. You're better off memorizing one hadith, one dhikr, one dua he made, than you are celebrating that day. Because every innovation is kulla bid'atin dhalalah. Every innovation is misguidance. May Allah make us from those who are firm upon the deen, upon the Quran and the sunnah, as lived and understood by the sahaba. And make us of those who truly, truly, truly love Allah and His Messenger. Allahumma qfir al-muslimin wal-muslimat wal-mu'minin wal-mu'minat al-ahiyan minhum al-amwat innaka antasmi'un qariib al-mujib al-da'wat ya muqallib al-qulub thabit qulubin ala dinik ya muqallib al-qulub thabit qulubin ala dinik ya muqallib al-qulub thabit qulubin ala dinik على القرآن والسنة يا أرحم الراحمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة أما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.